Welcome to the My Aged Care video that provides an introduction on how to configure your outlet information in the provider portal. By the end of this video, you should understand how to create a new outlet, add new service items under that outlet, activate the outlet so you can start to receive referrals, and deactivate and remove an outlet that is no longer needed. These functions are performed by an organization administrator or Outlet Administrator from the Outlet Administration tile from the Provider Portal homepage, or from the menu or toolbar within the portal. Only staff assigned the role of Organization Administrator in the Provider Portal can create new outlets. The mandatory fields must be completed. Outlets are used to receive and manage service referrals within My Aged Care. A new outlet card will then be created. To activate the outlet, at least one operational service item must be added. Information about how to configure service item information for each care type is explained in separate videos. You can then activate the outlet. The status of the outlet is displayed underneath the outlet name. To deactivate an outlet, you need to follow a similar process. A warning message will display to confirm that the outlet will be deactivated. This outlet will display as inactive in the provider portal and will no longer be displayed in the Service Finder tool or in any My Aged Care user portals. In order to remove an outlet, its status must first be set to inactive. Note that an outlet cannot be made inactive if there are accepted or commenced services in place. You can then remove the outlet and it will no longer display in the provider portal. That concludes the video on how to set up and maintain your basic outlet details. You can now set up and maintain information about the services you provide. There are specific videos that step through the process for each care type. To request changes to your contractual information, such as your organization's name, address, or contractually funded service information, you will need to contact your contract manager. For links and additional information and support, click the description box below.